comes to get angry.
Thank you.
Today, we celebrate two great pillars of the Church. Peter, the first among the Apostles, and Paul, the great preacher. We follow them as an example in our lives of faith, that we are to go out to the whole world and to proclaim the good news that Jesus Christ is Lord. And so, as we prepare to celebrate these sacred mysteries, let us call to mind our Savior.
Thank you. house. He was a cripple from birth, and they used to put him down every day near the temple entrance, called the Beautiful Gate, so that he could beg from the people going in. When he met Sir Peter and John on their way into the temple, he begged for them. Both Peter and John looked straight at him and said, "Look at us." He turned to them expectantly, hoping to get something from them. But Peter said, "I have neither silver nor gold, but I will give you what I have. In the name of Jesus Christ, the Nazarene, walk." Peter then took him by the hand and helped him to stand up. Instantly, his feet and ankles became firm. He jumped up, stood, and began to walk, and he went with them into the temple, walking and jumping and praising God. Everyone could see him walking and praising God, and they recognized him as the man who used to sit begging at the Beautiful Gate of the temple. They were all astonished and unable to explain what had happened to him. Word of the Lord.
Enthusiastic I was for the traditions of my ancestors. who had specially chosen me while I was still in my mother's womb, called me through his grace and chose to reveal his son to me, so that I might preach the good news about him to the pagans. I did not stop to discuss this with any human being, nor did I go up to Jerusalem to see those who were already apostles before me. But I went off to Arabia at once, and later went straight back from there to Damascus. Even when, after 3 years, I went up to Jerusalem to visit Cephas and stay with him for 15 days, I did not see any of the other apostles. I only saw James, the brother of the Lord. And I swear before God that what I have just written is the literal truth. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
challenged Peter, but in faith, and always accepting the various role for the service of leadership in the church. Now you're going to have to use a little bit of imagination, because a priest came and blew the page over, and the reader and John read the readings for the vigil mass, and not the ones I have prepared this homily for the readings of the day. But there you go. So the first reading that you wouldn't have, you would have heard about the death of St. James and the arrest and imprisonment of St. Peter. You'll know the story, Peter in prison, and then he's released by an angel. So this happens years after Peter has denied Jesus and then asked his pardon. Now Peter is strong and willing at this point to suffer for the Lord. The angel rescues Peter, and then it is said that eventually he ends up in Rome confessing the Lord and being crucified for him. The second meeting would have been about St. Paul, about his commitment to the Lord and setting out his role as an apostle. We have to remember his conversion and his initial hostility to Jesus and to the church itself. God himself touched the heart of St. Paul and then called him to follow him. Today, we also think about those who are following the Lord today and offering themselves in the sacred ministry of the church. It's quite often at this time of the year that ordinations happen. And at my first Mass, 11 years ago, Sister Mary Clare said this about what people look for in a priest. And it went something along the lines of this. He must be good at administration, but he must not spend too much time at his desk. He must run the youth club, but spend time with the oldies as well. He must like modern music, but be absolutely familiar with the English hymnal. He must take Holy Communion to those who are sick, but always be there to answer the telephone when someone rings. You get the idea. You get the absolute idea. He must be superhuman. Well, so often I hear my brothers and sisters in the church complaining or worrying about the high expectations people have, or even being bullied by their congregations. Remember, please, that your priest is a human being and he also has feelings. We have Peter and Paul, two different characters with different gifts. We all have different gifts and we should all use them in the service of one another and of the church. Pray for your priests, I hope you do, I'm sure you do. Pray for more vocations. Pray especially for those who are in a very uncertain time in the Church of England, that are still willing to jump out in faith and offer themselves to be priests. As we look at the personalities of Peter and Paul, we see that God called them to use their personalities to spread the gospel. Peter to use his impetuous wrath to look after the flock, and Paul to use his strength as a Pharisee and his strength of character to ensure that non-Jews would be welcomed into the church. It's a reminder to use our talents and to use our weaknesses too. These can become God's means of helping others if we allow him to use us. We don't have to be perfect for God to work through us. God can work through us, faults and all, just as he did with Peter and Paul. But we all have to take our share. We don't have to leave it to other people. We all have a vocation in the church, and we should all pray that God shows us our vocation and then carry it out with our whole hearts. Take a leap of faith, follow your heart.
begotten, not made, consubstantial with the Father, and through him all things were made. For us to remain in our salvation, begin now and ever. And by the Holy Spirit, all the promise of the blessed man, and the King of heaven. For our sake, he was crucified and conscious Christ. He suffered death and was buried, and rose again on the third day in accordance with the Scriptures. He ascended into heaven, and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again in glory to judge the living and the dead, and his kingdom will have no end. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Lord, the giver of life, who proceeds from the Father and the Son, who with the Father and the Son is adored and glorified, who has spoken through the prophets. I believe in one holy Catholic and Apostolic Church. I confess one baptism for the forgiveness of sins, and I look forward to the resurrection of the dead, and the life of the world to come. Amen.
We please then let us pray for the church and for the world, praying especially for those who will offer themselves in ordination at this time.
Jesus, Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners now rose and the bread rolls his holy church.
Thank you.
Peter, Clement, Sixtus, Cornelius, Cyprian, Lawrence, Christophorus, John, Paul, Osmanson, Damian, and all your saints. We ask that through their merits and prayers in all things we may be defended by your protecting hand. Therefore, Lord, we pray, graciously accept the salvation of our service, that of your whole family. Order our days in your peace, and command that we be delivered from eternal damnation, and come to the land of God for those you have chosen. Be pleased, O God, we pray, to bless, acknowledge, and approve this offering in every respect. Make it spiritual and acceptable, so that it may become for us the body and blood of your beloved Son, our Lord Jesus Christ. On the day he was to suffer, he took bread in his holy and venerable hands, and with eyes raised to heaven to you, his heavenly Father, giving you thanks, he said the blessing, broke the bread, and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you."
Thank you.
good things, O Lord. You sanctify them, fill them with life, bless them, and bestow them upon us.
Thank you.
silent. You're amazing. all the notices are on the DVD. To draw your attention, there's no mass on Wednesday or Thursday this week, as I should be. I know I said to you, try, it's all changed. Of course, most of you will have heard by now that Mavis, Margaret's mother, died peacefully on Monday. Obviously, Sunday, I can't remember, but Sunday is not on Monday. So I will be at the funeral to represent us on Wednesday. And I think there's a card at the back for us to sign. So if you do that today, I'll take it with you. So, I know that, no, sorry, there's two cards, don't worry. So please sign up for that. Friday night is the pamper evening. If you want to be pampered, it's 8 o'clock. 8 o'clock here in church, £2. Just turn up. Yes, suggested donation of £2. Do come to that if you're able. That's at 8 o'clock. Bring a towel with you. It's very good, I recommend it. Last time I had my meat done. It's very good. You'll notice that we prayed for two screens this morning. We're going to start now each week. We will pray for, I'm not going to say it's going to be Wednesday, two screens, but we'll try and split it out. And each house in that street will then receive a card saying that we prayed for them. So greet us all for doing that. You might need some help sometimes, so people might offer to help push things to the door. It's a good way of reflecting the people in that parish that we are here and having some prayer for them. So please do take a sheet home and pray for that street this week or two weeks. I think that's all I've forgotten anything. Good. Right, come and tell me what you've been doing this morning.
Let's
stand.